الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي Alhamdulillah, today the day one of Ramadan has gone and now we have entered into the second night of Ramadan and we will begin our fasting for the next day inshallah tomorrow morning. Inshallah, I hope and pray that you recited Juz 1 or Part 1 today or some part of it or you had some recitation in your day of Quranul Kareem. And inshallah, dear brothers and sisters, please make it this a habit that to have, even if you cannot recite the entire juz, try to recite some part of the Quran throughout the month of Ramadan. Inshallah, today we will do a summary of the second juz, which starts from ayah number 177 of Surah Al-Baqarah. And, you know, subhanAllah, we finished, yesterday we talked about Surah Al-Fatiha and what were the topics in? Juz number one, part number one of the Qur'an al-Kareem. And how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for a good portion gave you a comparison of two people who were sent the book previous to you and what was their reaction to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as a reminder, said, will we do the same thing as the previous nations did with their book of guidance? We have been given the Qur'an. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed us with the Qur'an. How seriously do we take the guidance of the Qur'an? Do we take it as a joke or do we take it as a word of God? It is something that we have to live by. And then subhanallah, The second just starts with the story of the change of the Qibla. You know, subhanAllah, at the end, at the last part of the first juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about Ibrahim and Ismail alayhim as-salam and their building of the Kaaba. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called it Mathabatan lin-nas and their building of the Kaaba. So in the first part of second juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the change of the direction of the Qibla, how Muslims were praying to Jerusalem and they were commanded to change their direction towards Masjid al-Haram. فَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ وَحَيْثُمَا كُنْتُمْ فَوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ شَطْرَهُ قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجْهِكَ فِي السَّمَاءِ فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا. We gave you a qibla which you would be pleased with. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Muslims to pray to the direction of Masjid al-Haram. And up until today, we are praying to that direction 5 times a day. So subhanAllah, at that change, there were some people who commented and who taunted the Muslims saying perhaps their prayers before this perhaps were not accepted or they were not counted. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rebuked that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you know, first the prayers were accepted and now likewise the prayers will be accepted. And you know, subhanAllah, that change of Kaaba happened. And then there's a story in that whole change of the direction of the Qibla. The change of the direction of the Qibla that people taunted or people commented. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in second juz gives a lot of commands, a lot of instructions. And there are a lot of Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about a lot of different things in the second juz. But subhanAllah, after that first initial command of changing the Kaaba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings a topic of sabr, patience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاذْكُرُونِي أَذْكُرْكُمْ. Remember me, I will remember you. Remember, as long as we obey the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we do as our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us to do. Allah said, أَذْكُرْكُمْ, I will remember you. Don't forget for a second that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will leave you alone. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the ayat of sabr, إِسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ. Seek patience, seek Allah's help in salah and in patience. And you know, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ, give glad tidings to the people who are patient. الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ, when musiba comes, when calamities come, they say, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. This came from Allah and we will all return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ. These are the people whom upon whom Allah's salawat, Allah's blessings are, and these are the rightly guided people. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought in that passage to affirm and to make us realize, you know, at the beginning when people taunt you, people comment, stay patient. أذكركم فاذكروني أذكركم. Remember Allah, keep on doing what He told you. Don't worry, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of you. But you have to be patient. And likewise in this surah, later on, in this chapter, in this juz, later on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَمْ حَسِبْتُمْ أَن تَدْخُلُوا الْجَنَّةِ وَلَمَّا يَأْتِكُمْ مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ خَلَوْا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مَسَّتْهُمُ الْبَأْسَاءُ وَالضَّرَّاءُ وَزُلْزِلُوا حَتَّى يَقُولَ الرَّسُولُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مَعَهُ مَتَى نَصْرُ اللَّهِ. You know, you think that you will just enter Jannah and the things that came on the nations before you will not come upon you as well. They were tested with hardship, poverty. Hatta zulzilu, hatta yaqula rasul, until the earth starting shaking under them. And even their prophet said, Mata nasrullah, when will the help of Allah come? Ala inna nasrullahi qareeb. Know that the help of Allah is very near. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you all these assurances. Amidst all the commands and all the instructions, He's going to tell us in the second juz. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, stay patient. فَاذْكُرُونِي, keep on remembering Allah. أَذْكُرْكُمْ, He will remember you. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ. Your Lord, the Lord of the world, He's one. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ. There is no one except for Him who's the most compassionate, the most merciful. Rahman and Rahim have a component of love. So Allah said that He's the most loving, He's the most merciful. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that passage tells the people, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. People who have believed, they loved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the most. You need love in order to obey the commands of Allah. This will not happen without patience. This will not happen without love. But Allah loves you. Allah will remember you for as long as you keep on doing your part. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be there for you. Ala inna nasrallahi qareeb. The help of Allah will be there. It is very near. But you will have to go through hardships in following all the commands of what of the religion. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you to, you have to do this. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this chapter talks about ayatul birr. What is righteousness? Allah said righteousness is not looking left and right. ليس البر أن تولوا وجوهكم قبل المشرق والمغرب. It is not just only speech. Speech and talk is cheap. It is actions. ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين. Bir is to have belief in Allah and on the day of judgment and upon the angels and upon the prophets and the books. وآت المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل. You know, righteousness, it is to give out the mal, the wealth that you love so much to your people, to your relatives who need it, and to the people who need it. And then, وَالْيَتَامَى, to the orphans, وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَبْنِ السَّبِيلِ, people who are travelers, to give this wealth to them. وَالسَّائِلِينَ وَفِي الرِّقَابِ وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةَ وَآتَ الزَّكَاةَ, to establish prayer, to give zakat. وَالْمُوفُونَ بِعَهْدِهِمْ إِذَا عَاهَدُوا, and to stay true to your promises. وَالصَّابِرِينَ فِي الْبَأْسَاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ, and to stay patient in poverty and in calamities and in hardships. This is birr. This is righteousness. It is not just saying that I'm righteous, but righteousness is proved through actions. That is what birr is. And Allah said, أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ صَدَقُوا. They are the people who are the truthful. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. They are the people who are the people of taqwa. The people of taqwa. Righteousness means we do actions. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers and sisters, brings in topics, instructions, starting with retribution, then fasting, that fasting has been prescribed upon you as it was prescribed upon the nations before you. Allah talks about Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about Hajj and how Hajj has been legislated. And in that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions a very important dua. He said, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا وَمَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. There are people who say, oh Allah, grant us the goodness of this world. They ask nothing of the hereafter. They will have nothing in the share of their in their hereafter. And then there are people, وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Oh Allah, give me goodness in this world and give me goodness in the hereafter. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ نَصِيبٌ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا. They are the people who will have a great share, you know, for what they did. You know, subhanAllah, this dua, you know, the place it comes, it is in the middle of the instructions of Hajj. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about some other instructions. And then right after this ayah, a few verses down, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu udkhulu fis silmi kaffa. O you who believe, enter into the religion completely, not selectively. You know, subhanAllah, this religion, this guidance which you asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for, Allah gave you Islam, Allah gave you Quran. It compromises of everything that you do in life, not just religion, but everything else in the world as well. So enter into this religion, accept this wholeheartedly and completely, not just selectively or not just based on your whims and desires, but completely as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told you. And then subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَسْأَلُونَكَ مَاذَا يُنْفِقُونَ. They ask you where to spend their wealth. قُلْ مَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ خَيْرٍ فَلِلْوَالِدَيْنِ وَالْأَقْرَبِينَ وَالْيَتَامَ وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ. Spent it on your parents and on your relatives and on the needy and on the orphans and the travelers. Spend your wealth in that way. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you instructions to uphold justice and to uphold qital and up to uphold, you know, whenever there is difficulty, uphold that, those principles. Because Islam, it is a complete way of life. It is not just, hey, it's my personal thing between me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, throughout this whole process of following the commands of Allah, you will have to rely on patience. You have to have that component of love. Remember, Allah loves you. Ala inna nasrallahi qareeb. The help of Allah will be there for you. But you have to be patient while doing, obeying all these commandments to the best of your ability. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, towards the one-third part, towards the end of one-third part of this juz, talks about the relationships between husband and wife. SubhanAllah, that is also part of your religion. That is not excluded from the commandments of Allah. That is not excluded from the guidance of Quran. That is also what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to do. He wants you to have a happy life, a beautiful life. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about divorce. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you specific instructions regarding divorce. Because that is the peak where fighting or where disruptions happens between couples. Allah said, فَإِمْسَاكُمْ بِمَعْرُوفٍ أَوْ تَسْرِيحٌ بِإِحْسَانٍ. Either hold on to your partner in good, in acceptable terms, or let her go with ihsan. Ihsan, let her go in an excellent manner, in an excellent fashion, with ihsan. SubhanAllah. And many times this word ma'roof is used. Ma'roof means in goodness, in acceptable terms, in amicable terms, or part your ways in what is acceptable and amicable between husband and wife. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, said, not all the time things will be rosy. There might be something difficult. There might be at times where people are not compatible with each other. If that is the case, separate your ways in the best possible manner. In the best possible fashion, go your separate ways. But do not do zulm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَمْسِكُهُنَّ ضِرَارًا لِتَعْتَدُوا وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ فَقَدْ ظَلَمَ نَفْسَهُ. If you hold on to your partners, and if you do zulm, and if you harm them, and bring some sort of oppression and injustice to them from their rights, وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ, whoever does that, فَقَدْ ظَلَمَ نَفْسَهُ. He's doing zulm. He's doing transgression upon himself, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold him accountable for on the Day of Judgment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, in this book has given you instructions of how to live a beautiful, happy life in this world. And that's why he said, come into this religion wholeheartedly, not just selectively. And you know, subhanAllah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the rulings and the instructions of divorce, before that, in regards to Ramadan, he mentioned, هُنَّ لِبَاسٌ لَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ لِبَاسٌ لَهُنْ. They are your garment and you are a garment for them. Husbands, you are a garment for your wives. Wives, you are a garment for your husbands. And you know, subhanAllah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed this issue of divorce. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, do it in the best possible way, in the most amicable way. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, حَافِظُوا عَلَى الصَّلَوَاتِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَسْطَى. Even in all that process, make sure you guard your prayers. You are steadfast on your prayers. You do not miss your prayers. You do not become negligent. And at the end of this part, and the end of this juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the story of Talut and Jalut, the Goliath, right? How only a few people overcame an army of many. Why? To make us realize it's never about wealth, it is never about numbers, but it is about following the commands of Allah and staying steadfast on them, and Allah will give you success in this world and in the hereafter, because you make this dua, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. Oh Allah, give me goodness in this world and goodness in the hereafter. But remember, you will have to go through patience, you will have to know that Allah's help will be there, but to remember, have love, believe in Allah, فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Have belief in Allah, Allah will respond to your prayers, but as long as you follow the commandments of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help will always be there. Remember, it's not about wealth and numbers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who is the all-powerful, He's the one in whose control everything is in this world, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, will make us die and resurrect us. Remember, we have to stay righteous, and righteousness means doing actions, not just saying words. So that is the message Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the second juz, second part of Qur'anul Kareem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us understand the Qur'an. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst the people of Qur'an. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from people who recite the Qur'an day and night. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow the Qur'an to intercede for us on the Day of Judgment. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our worship and our fasting and our charity and all the good deeds that we do. Jazakumullahu khayran. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Inshallah, now there will be the adhan of Isha.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. Allahu Akbar. La